All right, let's take a really high-level look at how a lithium-ion battery works and why they inevitably degrade. And we'll give you some tips on how to keep your electric vehicle's battery degradation at bay for as long as possible, too. Hi, I'm Lauren from Edmonds, where we're known as the car testing pros. We've teamed up with experts at CarMax to help you find the right vehicle for your needs. So battery degradation is a loss of capacity over time. And that's why your 2-year-old smartphone only lasts until noon instead of tomorrow like it did when it was new. So to understand why this happens, let's first talk about how the lithium-ion battery found in both your phone and your car works. Basically, a battery is 2 electrodes, which are just pieces of different metals separated by an electrolyte solution. On one side, you've got the positive electrode, called the cathode, which is like the lithium's home. It's nice and comfy, and the lithium just loves hanging out there. On the other side, you've got the negative electrode. This is the anode, which is like the nightclub. Lithium needs some convincing to get out of its home and go to the club. I mean, I can sympathize. In between is the electrolyte, which acts like a bouncer. It will let lithium through, but only as an ion. Apparently, this is a club with a dress code. Now, in our current setup, the lithium is just going to stay home. And if nothing inside this battery moves, we're not going to get any electricity. This is a discharge battery. So let's charge it up. Remember chemistry? Well, every atom is made up of a positively charged nucleus surrounded by negatively charged electrons. When you charge a lithium-ion battery, what you're doing is actually pulling electrons off the lithium atoms that are comfy at home and adding them over here in the club. Without its electrons, the lithium becomes a lithium-ion. Just like a magnet where positive and negative charges attract each other, the positive lithium-ion is dragged over to the club by the negative electrons waiting for it there. I used to have friends like that. The problem is, once the lithium is back with the electrons at the club, the bouncer, that electrolyte solution, won't let it back through to go home. So it's stuck. A bouncer not letting you leave? Sketchy for a nightclub, but perfect for a charged battery. When you attach this battery to a light bulb or smartphone or the electric motor in your car, all the electrons leave the club, running through that connection to power the light, phone, or car, and eventually getting home. Since the electrons have left, the lithium, an ion again, soaks back home past the bouncer. Rinse and repeat. Of course, there's not just one lithium atom and one electron in a battery cell. There are lots. And there's not just one battery cell either. An EV battery can be made up of hundreds of individual cells like this one. Unfortunately, this cycle of going to the club can't last forever, and that's where degradation comes in. Now, a few things happen inside the battery as it degrades. Another is that the structure of the electrodes can break down. Less room at home, less room on the dance floor at the club, which means fewer electrons moving back and forth. And these problems happen faster when the battery gets really hot, or you make the lithium ions and electrons move back and forth. So draining lots of power really fast, like stomping on the accelerator all the time, or charging up really fast, can make the battery hotter. And that heat can lead to faster degradation. Battery engineers have been working on this problem for a long, long time. Now, there are a few tactics all EVs use to try and prolong the usable life of their batteries. When you push the accelerator, they use a method called load balancing that spreads the power draw among all the cells. So no one cell is working too hard. Then there's thermal management, which tries to keep your batteries from getting too hot or too cold. They also limit your car's maximum charge. It's like putting an occupancy limit on the club's dance floor to keep it from getting too crowded. Usually, around 10 to 15% of your battery capacity is locked off by default, although some cars give you the option to charge more if you really need the extra range. But even with all of that, battery degradation is still a reality, but you can help. If you want your battery to age like a fine wine, instead of spoiling into vinegar, here's three easy steps you can take to keep your battery living as long as possible. First, try not to let your battery get to zero. Batteries are happiest between 20 and 80% charge when neither electrode is too crowded. After all, if you've ever been in a crowded club, you know things are more likely to get broken that way. While your EV is set up to keep the battery from overcharging, it can't stop you from running it down to empty every day. Second, use fast chargers as a sometimes thing. Yes, we know they're really convenient, but it's kind of like a big crowd trying to push through a single doorway. The intensity of fast charging can cause tiny cracks or other damage inside the battery, reducing how much charge the battery can hold. Fast charging is fine for road trips, especially if you're only charging to 80%. But around town, just charge at home when you can. Besides, most EVs can only use their maximum charging speed to the 80% threshold. Then they slow down to prevent this kind of damage. So there's not as much of an advantage to using a fast charger past that. And finally, if you live somewhere that gets really hot or really cold, try to park in a garage or in the shade where temperatures are more moderate, especially if you're charging. When you're out and about in a blizzard or a heat wave, there's not much you can do. Those temperature extremes affect the internal structure of the battery. If it's below freezing outside, it gets harder for the lithium ions to move, and they can wind up gathering on the surface of the negative electrode. It's called lithium plating, and it can reduce the capacity. If it's too hot, like over 120 degrees Fahrenheit, the battery ages prematurely. With all that internal damage we mentioned earlier, these will make your battery degrade even faster than it would have otherwise. The EV revolution is real, and driving one has real benefits. But there are some changes in lifestyle that come along with owning one. Now, scientists are working on the perfect battery. But until we have that, a little prevention can go a long way and keep that EV party going. Speaking of which, all this talk of clubbing has made me itching to go out. Oh, what are your technology questions? Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you next time.